Emily Rice at the UN in New York. Nine Chinese detainees have spent the night protesting on a roof at the Villawood Detention Centre in Sydney. They're threatening to jump later today if they aren't released into the community. It's understood the group arrived in Australia with student and tourism visas, which have since expired or been found to be fraudulent. They're the second group to protest on the roof this week. On Monday, a Fijian detainee jumped off the roof after he was told he was about to be deported. And for more on the issue of asylum seekers, we're joined by the National Coordinator for Refugees and Migrants for the Australian Tamil Congress, Bala Vigneswaran. Bala, good morning. Now, as far as the rest of the world is concerned, the war between the Tamils and the government forces in Sri Lanka ended in May of last year, but clearly things haven't returned to normal. Paint a picture for us that would see a man rather die in Australia than be sent back.
Thank you very much. In May 2009, formally the war was over. But the continuation is still going. Number of people were taken as prisoners by the Sri Lankan government. Many of them disappeared. Mm. There is no number as how many were taken by them. So those people are not there anymore. The families were wiped out. There is an Australian origin UN officer suggested that between 20,000 to 40,000 people were killed during that time. People are still struggling. 300,000 people were kept in a refugee camp. And some of them were released until recently. And they were told that they were going to be resettled in their native areas, which didn't happen. Many of them are blocked from doing it. In their areas, the Sri Lankan army or Sri Lankan armed forces are setting up the army camps, and the military families are going to be settled. The religion is not a problem. Buddhist temple is not a problem. Tamil people have no issues with that. But using that as a reason or an excuse to take their lands is a sad development, which Tamil people are not happy about.
So now describe the situation here in Australia. What is this frustration that these Tamil people are going through that would lead them to these sorts of protests?
The Tamil people, particularly the young men, they come through all kinds of hardships, surviving the Sri Lankan army and some other issues at the airport. They come through, they pay a lot of money, their life saving, their lands and all they sell to come through. But when they come, they have to wait at the Christmas Island for their refugee applications to be processed. Some of them are still waiting since late June last year. And they have to go through a security clearance process. That's why most of the people are waiting. In the meantime, the applicants have a process to go through. They have to be assessed by the Department of Immigration. If they don't get their way through, then they will be assessed by an independent reviewer. If that fails as well, they can apply for some kind of an intervention by the minister. And the people believe, and the applicants believe, they don't go through the fair process, they don't get proper legal support or migration assistance.
So it's this never-ending time scale that seems to be the biggest burden for them.
Unfortunately, there are lots of people from other countries who get their visas through without a problem, not a long time delay. And these people are waiting for months and months. That's the frustration. And they think this process can be a bit fairer and quicker.
Bala, thank you very much for coming in and having a chat to us about the situation out there. Bala Vigneswaran from the Tamil Congress here in Australia.
Thank you very much.